Going on, everyone. So yesterday, the Chicago Bulls eliminated the Atlanta Hawks from the playoffs or play-in. Chicago will now look to face the Miami Heat. Winner gets to play the Boston Celtics, so that should be a lot of fun. Unfortunately for Miami, Jimmy Butler looks like he may have an MCL issue. We'll find out more information, I'm sure, as we move closer and as we progress. But I really wanted Miami to play Boston, like, badly. Like, even going into the Sixers game, I really wanted Miami to play Boston. I was hoping Sixers would win the first game. Also, I was hoping that Milwaukee would have gotten the 2 seed, because I would have loved a Sixers-Bucks first round and then a Heat-Celtics. But if Jimmy Butler can't really be 100% or he's dealing with some issues, even if he kind of tries to play through it as he did in this previous game, I think Chicago probably the best chance, right, to make things interesting. And also from a Lakers standpoint, right? Like, you want Chicago or the Celtics to kind of be worn down as much as possible if the Lakers play them in the NBA Finals. But guess what? Two of the guys on the Atlanta Hawks is Trae Young and Dejounte Murray. Two guys that the Lakers are heavily expected to target this offseason. Two guys that are two stars that the Lakers very likely could acquire. Now, Trae Young is the guy that has just been heavily circulated. Trae's been linked to the Lakers since basically draft night, that he's always wanted to go to L.A. Kendrick Perkins not that long ago even was, like, talking about a star. Said he couldn't name the guy, but then he said it's going to be great for Anthony Davis, and everyone was like, okay, you should have just said Trae Young. Right? Like, this is not a surprise, no shocker there. And, you know, with the circumstances going on with Atlanta, they got to break the two guys up. Trae was, he was rough in the Bulls game. I'm willing to give him the benefit of the doubt because of his hand. You could tell that was really affecting him. He's just coming off of surgery. Most circumstances, he probably wouldn't even be playing at all. Right? If this was like in the regular season, he'd probably be sitting out until it was healed. But no, it's playoffs. They were trying to make a push. He was trying to get in some form of rhythm going into these play-in games. So I get it. But personally, look, I've talked about it heavily. If the Lakers land Trae, cool. Like, I'll be excited. I'll be pumped. We'll talk about it, right? I'm going to root for the guy that's on my team. He is a star. He is very talented. I just am not super sold on him. Now, Dejounte Murray, he was actually really good, very good in this Chicago Bulls game. He was, like, single-handedly keeping Atlanta or trying to keep Atlanta in that game. He was spectacular. I like Dejounte, especially if we end up losing D'Angelo Russell this offseason. I think a lot of that just comes down to how does D'Lo perform in the playoffs, right? How does he look in the Denver matchup and, you know, when the Lakers beat Denver going forward? Yes, when the Lakers beat Denver, that's right. But, you know, the Lakers could have acquired him this past trade deadline. They decided to wait, be patient, stand pat. Atlanta, you know, they're definitely going to look to move one of these two. I think, look, if I'm Atlanta, I would keep Dejounte Murray and trade Trae Young. I think that Atlanta is better equipped with Dejounte. I also think it'd be easier to kind of put the pieces around Dejounte, you know, and the assets, you'd get more of a return and you'd get more assets for Trae than you would for Dejounte, because Trae is age and just the name behind him. Where now you could maybe take all those assets and go get a more complimentary star when one becomes available alongside Dejounte. I just think it makes more sense from Atlanta standpoint to look to trade Trae Young. Thing is, like, how many teams are in the market for Trae? How many teams are going to want to line up to trade for Trae? Obviously, the Lakers apparently are one of them. To me, it just depends on what does the offseason look like? How do things shape up? I still am in the camp of Donovan Mitchell. Go get Donovan Mitchell. Right, if the rumors are true and it's the Lakers or the Knicks, well, the Knicks or the Lakers, if the Knicks end up deciding not to go after Donovan, then I think Lakers need to push their chips in and go get Donovan, because I just think Donovan and AD post LeBron would be great. And I also think Donovan alongside LeBron and AD would be better. I just think it's a better natural fit. It's just like with Trae, there's just so many concerns, right? Like, he's a guy that can completely win you a game by himself, without a doubt. He is incredible. When he's on, he is with the best of them. His playmaking, like, Anthony Davis would have so much of an easier time. Like, Trae Young is an upgraded D'Lo. is what Trae is. Trae is an upgraded version of D'Angelo Russell, right? He's not as efficient offensively as D'Lo has been, but he's still, like, that's the idea, right? A guy that can make plays, you know, at an elite level, hit the outside shot, right? Be a clutch guy, be a closer guy, not afraid of the moment, all that stuff. But much like D'Lo, you know, Trae isn't good on the defensive side. He's a liability on the defense side, even more than D'Lo, because at least D'Lo has the size and the length. But much like D'Lo, it's like when Trae's offense isn't clicking, which you just saw in that Chicago game, it's like he's literally unplayable. Right? I mean, he can make plays, and like he can still do other things, but it's just he's such a liability on the defensive side. And then when his offense isn't offsetting that, it just becomes a problem. And it's just like, I think you need a very specific team, right? If the Lakers get Trae, the Lakers are going to have to build a very specific team around Trae, LeBron, and AD. And then on top of that, like, how does Trae and LeBron play together? Because Trae is just so high usage, so on ball. Like, the big problem that DeJounte and Trae have is that both of them need the ball in their hands. They're both best as the point guard. But, you know, LeBron James being LeBron, he's going to be on the ball heavily. Now, will Trae make that sacrifice because he looks at it like, you know, like if there's any player in the league that Trae may look at and go, all right, he's better, it's probably LeBron, right? So, like, maybe Trae would look at it and go, okay, well, you know, if there's ever somebody that I would trust with the ball in his hands, it's probably LeBron. Like, because Trae is the better playmaker than DeJounte, but it's like, you know, he's probably looking at it as like, well, I'm better with the ball in my hands than DeJounte is. But does he look at LeBron and go, well, LeBron's kind of the one guy that is as good as me, you know, if not better? That's kind of a real question. But, you know, on paper, if it works, good luck beating the Lakers. All right, because Trae would solve a lot of, like, the things that Lakers, like a closer down the stretch, a guy that can hit shots, a guy that can take pressure off of LeBron James and Anthony Davis, a guy that can make things easier for Anthony Davis, easier for LeBron, handle the ball and playmaking duties, all that stuff. Obviously, turnovers are a concern with him. He does get a little careless at times. But, you know, the idea makes a lot of sense. It's just, there's a lot of questions of, can it translate? And then, you know, DeJounte Murray, I like DeJounte, and I'm still game for getting DeJounte. It just, again, depends on the price. What is the price for DeJounte? If you lose, another reason I really like DeJounte is because you can get more, right? So, like, what if you get a DeJounte and, like, say, like a Clint Capella, right? And then you can kind of piece some things together and maybe go get, or maybe even go get a shooter. Like, you can get, like, three guys from Atlanta for the price of Trae Young. The problem is like, you're going to trade everything to go get Trae, which I get he's young. Like, Trae is young enough to where even post Anthony Davis, right? Not even just post LeBron, but even when Anthony Davis's contract expired, Trae would still only be like 28, right? So, like, you could still kind of have that star long term. But to me, it's like with DeJounte, I like the idea of, like, you go get DeJounte, he's on a good contract going forward, and then you can get more complementary pieces around him. And a lot of the same stuff with Trae, you can kind of still get with DeJounte, but I just think you get have better pieces, right? And more depth and more overall just talent. Where Trae, I just feel like you're a lot more limited. No, Trae, I think, is the better player, but I don't, like, DeJounte isn't a slouch. Like, DeJounte is really good, right? And he can just do so much and do a lot of the same things. I just think, like, you know, even if you do keep D'Lo, I don't hate the idea of DeJounte, because D'Lo's just been so good off ball and shooting the basketball, right? Like, you could have DeJounte and then on top of him have D'Angelo Russell to kind of make plays and hit shots and kind of be complimentary. And then DeJounte, you're hoping that he can get back to being that defensive stopper. If he can get back to being the defensive stopper, then you're really good, right? Now you got some athleticism, point of attack, got some good size, some good length at the guard position between him and D'Lo. Like, I think that could shape up nicely and then you don't have to have the concerns, right? You could always, you could also always have one of the Dejounte or D'Lo on the court at all times. But to me, it's more so like, if they lose D'Lo, I like the idea of going and getting Dejounte, right? Like, can you go get Dejounte and then maybe look to go get some other complimentary pieces? Like I said, maybe add a Capella to the deal. If you can't get Capella, right, maybe you can move some stuff, get create some flexibility, maybe go get like a Valanciunas. You know, I just think that just Dejounte just gets you more flexibility is my point. That's why I kind of like him more. But anyway, as always, this is a discussion. Pass a question on you. Let me know your thoughts and opinions down in the comments below. What do you think? How do you feel? Do you like either of these guys? Obviously, the rumor mill has already begun. I mean, the Lakers still have to go handle business and beat Denver. But, yeah, I mean, with given the circumstances of Atlanta being out and eliminated, and all, like, the questions circulating around Trae and Dejounte, I mean, it kind of makes sense. I get it. But, you know, again, how do you feel? What are your thoughts are? I'd love to hear it. So let me know down in the comments below. That being said, if you haven't liked this video, hit that like button. Helps me a lot. It's when you enjoy these types of videos, and I truly appreciate it. Not subscribe channel, hit that subscribe button. Turn on the bell notifications. Appreciate y'all. See you in the next one. Thank you.